Keep going, don't stop.
I think the mass majority are down here.
Yep.
Really?
Enemy is hit. One of our tracks was hit.
Oh, they attacked it out there and we're tapping.
We nailed it back.
We've lost anyway.
Oh my god, I survived it. Unbelievable. What did we get there? Spartan. Crikey.
Let's get this show on the road!
Alright, Mr. Stug, you just cut me off. Alright. You have fun over there, yeah?
Yeah, same. And as usual, our scout isn't moving.
We're moving.
Hit it with the scouts, we're on the scout.
Hit him, what am I doing?
We've got them! Looks like that one went right through.
Teammate bugged out and left him. Boom. Just disappeared, took blind shot and it got him. Better.
We'd have done better if the scout had gone first and just lit him up.
Well, we held off. It was me and a T1 and we held off about five of them over on that corner because they couldn't get round. He seemed to know what he was doing, that T1 heavy as well. Okay guys, this is, I believe, the first game I've recorded without Blade. He was AWOL, no idea where he was. I thought I'd take out the trusty old KV-1S for a spin. We have been using the IS-3 and the AT-15 quite a lot recently because I've been grinding up the Russian line and Blade was grinding his AT-15 to get to the tortoise. So as I say, I'm in the KV-1S here and I'm going up to the train tracks on the hill to see if I can possibly spot some tanks and put down some early damage while the backup is still on its way. Get a nice early hit there, and luckily I deflect the returning shot. Got to be careful here if I show the front of my tank coming over now with them knowing I'm there.
They're going to put a
nice big dent in me. So, slowly going over.
Gotcha.
And another nice hit there, and another bounce. There's a fair few over there. I've got back up here in a KV-1. So I decided to move up a little bit, not too far, and see if I can get a few more extra hits on this group running in between buildings. I'm not exactly sure what went on with that shot there. Seemed to be light blade, AWOL. The massing on the edges of buildings, but this guy keeps coming outside. Oh.
We nailed it back.
There you go, better hit. He's a little bit he's in a bit of trouble there. But again, why he's coming out on his side, I have no idea. See if he's daft enough to come out again. Nope, he just got blown up there, didn't he? Okay, we have an AT.
Enemy armor is damaged.
Another nice hit on the side there. All seems as if they want to do a suicide run in between these buildings.
They're hit.
Just took the tracks there.
The radio man is bleeding. We can't rely on him.
Took a big hit. To run away. Let's actually go a little bit sheepish here because I'm obviously thinking one big hit off that 80.
We finished him off.
But I managed to get him first, which is a bonus. It frees me up a bit to move up. Still got my guys down here, so I know my left flank is fairly safe, and it allows me to push on up closer to the spawn point. We have a couple of extra tanks. Good thing is with our team here, we are all close by together. Looks like we have an AFK tank. Towards our spawn. No, he's moving. But we do have a little bit of defence, so he's going to spot anything early and we can get back if needed, so we decide to head towards the camp. If they are on the way back to ours, I decided to jump in the cap here, which would hopefully stop them moving up towards ours and getting them coming back. I cannot believe all I did was track him from there. As predicted, they are coming back to try and stop the cap. Like I say, most of our guys were close by. They're picking them off one by one as they come. this point I'm feeling fairly safe. Just use the cover of the building on the left. I keep my eyes out in front. Got a few guys here with me now as well, so we're going to light up anything if it does decide to come round the back. But basically this game in my eyes is... So there we go, not a bad game. Put a bit of damage down. Managed to cap the point. Got my times free. Gave me a nice boost in the XP there.